Does this look familiar? Well, it might be if you have this. A while back, I decided to experiment with a precise cutter for my project, so I got myself this CO2 cutter called K40, and it's the reason I made this. If you own a manual CO2 cutter like the K40, then you are very familiar with this scene. You put a piece of green tape on mirrors, you zap-zap, adjust, then repeat until everything is aligned. I got tired of it, and I was looking for an easier solution. This is when I came across a post of someone talking about how they use an LED ring as a pointer. Then I realized I can actually use that for alignment as well. So this is when I decided to make this. It is basically a PCB with LED arranged in a ring shape in the center, and it extends on two ends to allow for mount screws and power. In theory, the laser can simply pass through the center hole uninterrupted, and the LED lights can travel along and parallel to it, forming a halo around it. Unlike the CO2 laser, the LED light is visible and can easily be used as a guide to align our mirrors and lens without firing the CO2 laser or even turning the machine on. I like that much more than using the CO2 laser itself to burning tape pieces. It is also much safer and faster. But the real question is, does it actually work? Yes. Here you can see the ring visible on all mirrors. It also doubles as a pointer to identify the laser projected location. Normally, before I start a job, I fire a low power beam to make a tiny burn to align my starting point. However, using this pointer, I don't have to do that anymore. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. Back to the LED ring. Now that I have tested it and know it works, there are a couple of more things I want to do before I permanently install it. First, I want to lower the resistance for the LED resistors. Here, I used 1K ohm resistors, but if I lower that a little more, I can make the LEDs brighter, allowing them to work in brighter condition. And second, I want to permanently fix it in place to the metal case using screws. This will ensure the PCB doesn't move. The last thing I want is for the ring to move and get in the way of the CO2 laser starting a fire. That's why I included those two holes in the PCB design. Last but not least, powering the ring itself using the K40 power supply. At the moment, to simplify the setup, I am using a long USB cable plugged in directly into the wall. It would be nice if I don't have to worry about that plug and have it powered directly from the machine, so it comes on automatically and off with the machine. However, I'm still hesitating if I should install it or not. On one hand, it is handy, it works, and it makes my life easy. On the other hand, it can potentially burn the house down.
What?
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 What do you think? Is it worth it? Thank you for watching.